What we're doing right now is a treatment of cotton textiles, and we use sulfuric acid as a catalyst to break this down into its sort of components that make up the entire cotton fabric. And since we do this lab scale, I need to do everything myself, which means that I need to mix this mixture, the cotton pieces and the acid together manually. And that I have to do every 5 or 10 minutes because we want to get an even coating of the acid on the textiles. And then we take this mixture when we've added the water and we put it in a pressure cooker to cook it. And that will completely disintegrate or completely decompose the cotton. The end result is a glucose solution, high concentration, so you get this amber colored solution. One lucrative or an attractive option is to take the glucose, the sugar formed, and transform it into the building blocks for synthetic fibers, virgin synthetic fibers, like spandex or nylon, for instance. One advantage with this is that we keep the value of the textile waste within the same value chain. So we help decrease the amount of waste that the textile industry produces at the same time as we also help to decrease the amount of raw material that the textile industry uses.
I've spent weeks sorting textiles by hand for myself in the beginning of my research, but for a large-scale recycling process of textiles, we need a functional and efficient way of separating and sorting the textiles, the different textiles. Okay, so this facility, SipTex, using cutting-edge technology to separate different textiles from a waste textile stream. And for me to be able to conduct my research, I need a reliable and pure cotton material. And this is what I get from SipTex.